It's me, Antine.
And me, Ariel.
Thank you so much for joining us. We are so excited that we're in another week of our Cross Trainers series, where we learn how to train our spirits so that we can stand firm in God's truth. Now, Ariel, I am wondering, what is your favorite junk food? And you at home, you can think as well. What junk food do you just absolutely love?
I really like pizza because I can fool myself into thinking it's healthy because it has vegetables on top. But I know that's not true, but I love pizza.
I mean, pizza's a vegetable, isn't it? Depends what you put on it, yeah.
That is true, that is very true. What is your favorite junk food, Antine?
So my favorite junk food is a big, juicy, cheesy burger from Rocco Mama's.
Oh, my word.
I'm getting so hungry just thinking about it. Now today, we are gonna talk about not putting junk food in our minds, but being disciplined by eating God's word, the Bible.
Putting the paper and all of that, that doesn't sound like a test good answer.
Not literally eating God's word, but feeding your mind with God's word. But anyway, I think Ariel should stick around for the lesson.
I think I should.
Before we get into it, it's time for our
icebreaker. What is our icebreaker this week? We will be listening to different sounds and then trying to guess what those sounds are. So why don't you play with us? These things will come on the screen. And how about you guess too? Let's go into it. Wow, that was such a fun game. I don't know how many I got right because I'm not so good at that. But now we're just gonna pause for a little bit and go into a time of worship and just focus on God and love Him and sing to Him. Worship is an amazing space to just connect with God. So let's go into worship now.
Just one word, you calm the storm that surrounds me. Just one word, the darkness has to retreat. Just one touch, I feel the presence of heaven. Just one touch, my eyes were open to see. My heart can't help but believe. There's nothing that our God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can't move. Oh, praise the name that makes a way. There's nothing that our God can't do. Just one word, you heal what's broken inside me. Just one word. will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like the power of Jesus. I will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like the power of Jesus. I will believe for greater things. There's no power like the power of Jesus. Let faith arise, let all agree. There's no power like His power. There's nothing that God can't do. There's not a mountain that He can't move. Oh, praise the name.
Hey guys, my name is Dina and I am a medical student, which means I'm busy studying and learning to be a doctor one day, which is really exciting, but it makes for quite a busy day. So on a normal weekday, I'll wake up early, I'll drive through to the hospital, and I get to learn from the doctors. I get to help patients and also get to practice some of the skills that I'm learning. Then I come home and I have to study. So I have to learn all of the things that I saw that day. I need to learn how to diagnose patients, how to treat patients, and also how to handle emergencies. All of this is super important, but it takes up a big chunk of my day. And in the midst of all of that, I still have to find time to see my family, to talk to my friends. So it can make for a busy, exhausting day. And then I go to sleep. And guess what? I have to wake up the next morning and do it all over again, which can be exhausting. But that's what diligence is. Diligence is doing something every single day in order to get good at it, to do something well. So if I want to be a good doctor one day, I have to do that. I have to get up every day and work hard. But like I said, this can be tiring and this can be exhausting. So where do I get that strength from? How do we find strength to be diligent every day? And I want to let you guys in on a little tip, a little secret that really helps me, and it's where I find my strength for the day. And for me, it's all about how I start my day. So I have to wake up a little bit earlier and make time to spend time with God. Whether that be reading my Bible or praying or listening to some worship music, it really helps me to spend time with God at the beginning of the day to get strength to face whatever is coming at me that day. Because not only do I need strength to be diligent and study and work hard, but also I'm often in the day faced with things that are kind of scary. Things that I don't think I can handle, not in my own, I don't feel strong enough. So being able to talk to God in the mornings and get that strength from Him, it helps me to be courageous, to be brave. And that's something that I need in the day. Not only do I need to work hard, but I need to be brave. And it all is so much easier if I rely on God's strength and not my own strength. And we're all at some point called to work hard or to be brave. And I think a little diligence in your spiritual life, in finding time to talk to God, and a little diligence in your relationship with God really helps you in your diligence in all the other areas of your life. If you need to be brave, or you need to work hard, or you need to do something scary, it really, really helps. So yeah, that's a little tip from me. But I better go. I'm on my way to the hospital, as you can see. But yeah, bye guys. Talk to you soon.
How amazing was that?
So amazing.
So cool. Every week I get challenged just to be disciplined and to do small things every day to eventually achieve something big. And I'm wondering if there's something that you want to become one day. And maybe right now when you're in school, even if you're not back at school, but you're starting to do some schoolwork, you can just start thinking about your future and how working hard in your week now is going to help you one day.
Very true.
But right now, it's time for our moments to just be still and to pause and slow down. So wherever you are, make sure you're sitting comfortable. Maybe you can just take a few deep breaths. And we're just going to focus on Jesus and start getting ready for today's lesson. I'm sure a lot has happened in your week and that some things are on your mind right now. While you take a few deep breaths in and out, I want you to think of something that was hard for you this week. Is there something that happened that upset you? Or maybe you are feeling angry or frustrated about something. God cares about everything going on in your life, and He is with you. In your heart, or out loud if you want, tell God about this thing and ask Him to help you to know just how much He loves you and how He is with you. And while you think about that, I'm going to pray for us. Father, you are so good and so kind and so loving. Thank you that we can share all the difficult things with you and also all the good things in our lives. Thank you that you care about us and that you care about every single detail. Will you help us today to hear what you want to say to us and what you want to teach us? In Jesus' name, amen. Now let's get ready for the scripture reading.
Romans 12 verse 2. Do not conform to the patterns of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, so that you may discern what is the good, pleasing, and perfect will of God. In today's lesson, we will be talking about our thoughts. A thought is an idea or an opinion that comes through what we think in our minds. Our thoughts are important to God. Do you know why? Our thoughts control our ideas and what we believe. These ideas and the things we believe affect the way that we behave, how we feel, and what we do. That is why these thoughts are important to God. God cares about what we think in our minds. He cares about what we think about Him. He cares about what we think about ourselves, about what we think about the people around us, and about the world that we live in. Because all of these things affect the way that we feel and how we act. So, what are we supposed to be thinking then? Our Bible verse for today tells us that we must not conform to the patterns of this world, but that we should be transformed by renewing our mind. Simply put, this actually means that we should not follow or copy the ideas and the beliefs of this world. And by this world, it means the things of this world that do not make God happy. Instead, we are told that we must be transformed or changed by replacing the ideas that don't please God or make Him happy with beliefs and ideas that are in His Word. God gives us those beliefs and ideas through the Bible, His Word, and through the Spirit. Today, I'll be talking about the little things that we can do to renew our minds and think thoughts that are pleasing to God, thoughts that help us believe and act in the way that makes God happy. Some of our thoughts are thoughts that we choose to think. For example, if I am having a fun time this weekend with my friends, I choose to sit down and think about just how fun it will be. I think about what I will wear and what we will eat. These are choices, and those thoughts end up in my mind because I choose to think those thoughts. The other type of thoughts we have are thoughts that we don't really think about. These are thoughts that just appear in our heads. Sometimes it could be a song that is stuck in your head and you just can't get rid of it. Other times, it's dreams or thoughts that are not really good thoughts about other people. Sometimes we don't actually think about these thoughts or choose to think about these thoughts, but they appear in our minds anyways. Whether it is thoughts that we choose to think or thoughts that just pop in our head, These thoughts in our minds happen because of what is happening around us. For example, what we hear, what we see, what we speak about, what we do, and where we go. I have an example of this in my own life, about thoughts that started appearing because of what I did. A few weeks ago, a friend of mine suggested that I watched this show. I wasn't really keen to watch it, but I thought, why not? I started watching it and I was hooked. I watched it every single day. It was like a series. Anyways, I didn't think it was any harm. I just thought, well, it's just a show. What will it do to my mind? And then I started realizing that my thoughts began to change. It affected the way I looked at myself and what I believed about the way I looked. I also started to speak to people around me like the people in this show did. I also began to be a little bit unhappy with the things in my life because I was comparing it to the people in the show. I didn't choose to think these thoughts, but they would pop in my head because of what I was watching, what I was putting in my head. I want to show you a little bit of an analogy that gives you a picture of how the things in our life affects our thoughts. This little glass represents our mind. I don't think you have a mind this small, but for the purpose of this object lesson, just bear with me. This empty glass represents our mind. And in this jug over here, I have this murky water. It's actually coffee, shh. But it represents some of the negative things in our lives that affect our thoughts. So I'm going to open it and show you how we can often fill our minds with thoughts that are not good. So for me, it was a show I was watching. That's a little bit in my mind. It could be for you or for anyone else, the games that you play. If those games are violent and maybe have evil imagery and are just not good for your mind, you fill your mind with it. It could also be the music that you listen to. If it speaks negatively about people and disrespects people and just uses bad language, it fills your mind. It could also be spending too much time on your smartphone, if you have a smartphone, and comparing your life to other people on social media. All of these things affect what goes into your mind and become your thoughts. It could also even be listening to gossip and speaking about other people badly. The more we hear, speak, and watch things that affect our mind negatively or in a bad way, the more we are filling our minds with thoughts and beliefs that pull us away from God. And as a result, we begin to believe the lies that are not in the Word of God, the lies of the enemy. I knew that the thoughts I had were not true, the thoughts from watching this show. So I had to do the right thing, and the right thing to renew my mind. So if this represents watching the show, I had to stop, put it away and stop watching the show. Close that lid, whether it's the games, it's watching, spending too much time on your smartphone, put the thoughts away. But as you can see, our mind is still full of things. Just stopping doesn't necessarily help renew our mind or change the way that we think. That's why we have this over here. Here, I have a jug full of clean water. This clean water represents the Word of God and everything that is true in the Word of God, as well as all the good habits that we can replace with all the bad habits we have in order to change the way we think and begin to view God the way He wants us to in His Word. So, we can replace our mind. Here is my cup with all the bad thoughts. We can replace it by beginning to read the Word of God. We can read His Word. We can listen to music that glorifies God. We can have conversations that are kind. We can spend less time playing violent games, but play games that are educational for us.
Can you see how it's starting to change? We can have conversations with people, encourage people, spend time with God. And as we fill our minds with the things that are good for us, as you can see, the thoughts have changed. It's no longer the bad, unhealthy, or negative thoughts in our minds, but rather our minds will now be full of what God wants us to be thinking and the things that glorify Him and make us His children. Over the past few weeks, we have been talking about discipline. I'm going to put this aside. Discipline is the little things that we can do in our daily lives to improve ourselves. And just like we need to train our bodies to be fit and healthy, and eat right, and everything that we fill our bodies with end up affecting what our body is like. Just like that, we need to train our minds as well. We need to put things in our mind that is healthy for our relationship with God and help us build and live a life that is more pleasing to God than all the negative things we have. One of my most favorite Bible verses also speaks about our thoughts. It's in Philippians 4, verses 8 to 9. It says, "Finally, brothers and sisters, whatever is true, whatever is noble, whatever is right, whatever is pure, whatever is lovely, whatever is admirable, if anything is excellent or worthy of praise, think about those things. Whatever you have learned or received or heard from me," this is Paul, "or seen in me, put into practice, and the God of peace will be with you." This verse tells us that the best thing for us and for our minds is to think thoughts that are good and godly. And in order for us to think such thoughts, we need to be transformed by the renewing of our minds, which means replacing all the bad things around us with good things so that it affects our minds. Just as our Bible verse tells us, this means replacing the thoughts in our heads with thoughts that are pleasing to God, thoughts that are true, that are noble, which means honor other people and honor God, thoughts that are right, that are pure, lovely, thoughts that are admirable, that you can admire, thoughts that are excellent and worthy of praise. We can do this by making the decision to change what we watch, how we speak, where we go, and the things we do so that it reflects who we are as children of God. Two ways we can do this is making the decision to stop doing the things that give us bad thoughts and spend time doing more good things for our minds. For the thoughts that we can't control, we need to make a decision to not entertain them. Sometimes they just pop in our head, but we need to make the decision to stop them just as quickly as they popped in and instead remember all the things that are true from the Word of God. So remember, all of this is to say, the only way to renew your mind or replace the thoughts that are of the world with the thoughts that are godly is to replace it with the truth of the Word of God, the Bible. So here's an activity for your head. Memorize this verse for today as a reminder that your thoughts are important. Romans 12 verse 2, "Do not conform to the patterns of this world, but be transformed by renewing your mind." For your heart, name one thing in your life that makes you think good thoughts, and then name one thing in your life that makes you think bad thoughts. It could be games or movies, and discuss this with your parents. And finally, what you can do with your hands or your actions. Give that one thing in your life up that affects you negatively. Give it up for 1 week and just see how it affects your thoughts. Maybe by the end of the week, you'll see that you have more positive thoughts about yourself, about God, and about others. Thank you for joining us for this week of Cross Trainers. We will see you.
Thank you for joining us again, kids. I hope that was helpful to you. Let's remember to apply this stuff in our daily lives and not just listen to it and forget what it is about.
Yeah, so check out the challenges at the end of this video.
Absolutely. Those do help to apply it as well. So until next time, we will see you again. Goodbye.